यतिकृतनियमरहितां ख्यादैकमयीम् अनन्यपरतन्त्रां नवरसरुचिरां निर्मितिम् आदधति भारती कवेर्जयति. वि आर् लुकिङ्ग् एट् दोषस्. जस्ट् टु रीकेप्, वि सा द पददोषस् एण्ड् देन् नौ वि आर् आन् टु वाक्यदोष. In the Vakya Doshas, we are looking, we saw until Avimrishta Videyamsha. Now we will be looking at Viruddhamatikrit. Let me take up that. In Viruddhamatikrit, as far as Padagata Dosham is concerned, we saw the word Akarya Mitram in that, where it is either Akarye Yaha Mitram Bhavati or Karya Mitram Yaha Na Bhavati Saha Akarya Mitram. So there is a problem there, where it gives rise to a different meaning, which is different from the vivaksha. Whatever the author is trying to say, the meaning that arises in our mind is completely different, or it is viruddham, which is opposing to the idea that the poet wishes to convey. So that is viruddham atikrita. The shlokam that Mamata gives is shrita kshama rakta bhuvaha शिवालिङ्गितमूर्तयः विग्रहक्षपणेनाद्य शेरते ते गतासुखाः. इट् इस् ईजियर् टु अण्डर्स्टाण्ड् बिकास् इट् इस् वाक्यगतं. देर् आर् मेनि वर्ड्स् इन्वाल्व्ड् हियर् विच् गिव् रैस् टु एन् आपोसिङ्ग् मीनिङ्ग्. दट्स् वै ऐ गेव् दिस् टेबल्. वेर् एस् इन् दि पदगतम् इट् इस् ओन्लि इन् वन् पदं दट् द दोषम् एक्सिस्ट्स्. हियर् मेनि पदस् हाव् दट् दोष. द ऐडिया हियर् इस् someone is describing kings who have given up their thirst for killing, or their thirst for acquiring lands, that is the thirst for the war. So they have given up that, and vigraha kshapaneena, because they have given up their yuddha, the desire for yuddham, te gatasukaha शेरते अद्य. अद्य ते शेरते. सो द मेन् सेण्टेन्स् हियर् इस् अद्य ते राजानः शेरते. दे आर् रेस्टिङ्ग् इन् पीस्. दे हेव् गिवन् अप् वार् एण्ड् दे आर् शेरते इस् एक्चुलि लिटरल् मीनिङ्ग् इस् दे आर् लैङ्ग् डौन्. बट् हियर् वी केन् से दट् दे आर् रेस्टिङ्ग् इन् हेप्पिलि गत असुखाः, विदौट् एनी असुखम् और् दुःखं. दे आर् हेप्पिलि स्पेण्डिङ्ग् देयर् टैम्. The every adjective here, which is in Bahuvachanam, Prathama Vibhakti, are all adjectives to te, which is Rajanaha. So, Shrita Kshamaha, Rakta Bhuvaha, Shivalingita Murtayaha, Gata Sukhaha Rajanaha, Vigraha Kshapanena, Adya Sherate. So, Adya, today, te Rajanaha, those kings, Sherate, are resting. How are they resting? Shrita Kshamaha. Krama is Kshanti. That is forgiveness. They Shrita Kshamaha. They are, let's say, Ashrita Kshantihi Yehi Te. 1 minute, let me. They kshantihi is forgiveness, so they easily forgive people. They are not going for war because they are angry with someone. So shrita kshamaha. Kshama is the quality of kshanti or forgiveness which they have adopted. Shritaha, ashritaha. The next one is rakta bhuvaha, bhumi. Bhuhu is bhumi, and raktaha, anuraktaha, they are attached to the bhumi. So the, or the earth is attached to them. Anurakta bhuhu yeshu. So which means the prajaha. Bhuhu is not just the earth, but lakshanaya, it indicates the people who are there in this bhumi. So the prajaha, the subjects of the country, are also anuraktaha. They are very attached to the king. They like what he is doing, so rakta bhuvaha. So anurakta bhuhu yeshu rajasu te. Next is shivalingita murtayaha. Shiva is mangalam. So mangalayana kalyanena alingitaha sambaddhaha murtayaha sharirani. The very sight of them, even the darshanam of those people, those kings who have let go of war, it is Shiva. or it is kalyanam, auspiciousness. So they are not doing inauspicious things like killing and all that. So kalyanena alingita shariraha te rajanaha gata asukhaha dukkharahitaha. They don't have any dukkham. And in that manner, vigraha kshapanena, vigraham yuddham, and tasya kshapanena tyagena adya te rajanaha sherate. They are happily gatasukaha sherate without dukkharahitaha vartante. Now the meaning, each word has double meaning and it gives us a viruddha artham in our mind. So the vivaksha, what the poet wishes to say is one thing, which is describing how kings who have let go of war, let go of that thirst for war, behave. Whereas the mati, the idea that comes into our mind using the double meaning is vigraha kshapanena. Vigraha is also shariram. Kshapanena, again, tyagena. When the body, when someone has let go of their body or they are dead, the entire description is of a corpse or a person who has just died in a battlefield. So shrita kshama, kshama is also bhumi, kshama also means kshanti, forgiveness. So here they are lying down, bhumi patitaha, they are lying down on the floor because they have fallen down, they have been killed in the battlefield. So shrita kshamaha, ashrita bhumi yehi. Next is rakta bhuvaha. Raktam is rudhiram also, and anuraktam. Anuraktam is attached, whereas here the viruddha meaning that comes up is rakta bhuvaha rudhirasya sthanabhutaha or rudhira adharaha bhavanti. The blood is flowing out of them. So it immediately gives rise to a jugupsa also in our mind, where we want to describe the shantarasam. It gives us the idea of jugupsa also. Then it is when the viruddha rasa comes to our mind, that is a dosham also. So you can take this as an example for rasa dosham also. You can take this as an example for vakya gatam. So in one shloka itself, there can exist many dosha. So here it is actually viruddham atikrita vakya gatam. You can also have a rasa dosha here. But let's go with what Mammata has given here. So rakta bhuvaha rudhirasya adharaha bhavanti rajanaha and shiva lingita murtayaha. Shiva is a female jackal. So when a corpse is lying in the battlefield, the jackals immediately come because they are all animals of prey. So they surround the corpse and try to get the mamsam from it. So shiva alingita murtayah, their bodies are being approached by, or they are being approached by the she jackal, which is shiva. Shivaha is a male jackal, shiva is a female jackal. So shiva alingita murtayah, first it is the female which hunts, and then the male just comes and happily enjoys. That is the animal behavior. So shiva lingita murtayaha kroshtri bihi alingita shariraha. The last one is gata sukhaha. Gata sukhaha, gata asu kha. Asu is prana, kha is indriya. For those who do not have their pranan and indriya, the functionality of their indriyas is lost, or they have lost their prana, and they have lost their prana, such people are, it seems as if such people are being described in the shloka. So the poet wants to actually praise the kings who have given up their war attitude, but he ends up describing someone who is very, who is dead, which is not the desired. So here is the viruddha matikrita dosha. Let me take up the text. Shirita kshama rakta bhuvaha shivalingita murtayaha vigraha kshapanayanadya sheratete gata sukhaha atra kshamadi guna yuktaha sukham asate iti vivakshite. So what is the vivaksha? Vivaksha is vaktum iccha, whatever the poet wishes to convey. Yeah, you have a doubt? Tell me. You've muted yourself. I think you have to unmute yourself. Hello? Hello. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, now it's connected.
Yes, tell me.
I'm unable to see the text, ma'am.
Oh, you want the text also? Okay, I will.
Yeah.
Okay, fine, sure. So I just keep shifting from the slide to the text. So sometimes the screen may be off. So I will do that. So Atra Kshamadi
Not
Gunayuktaha.
this one, the previous one. What?
That one is here. Is this the one that you want?
Slide. Is there any option?
For what? अत्र क्षमादियुक्ताः सुखम् आसते इति विवक्षिते हताः इति विरुद्धा प्रतीतिः. Now, for this is the vritti for the shlokam that he has given. So this shloka has the dosham, and what is the dosham? He explains in the vritti. So atra asmin shloke kshamadigunayuktaha rajanaha the kings who have that quality of, that is the idea that the poet wishes to convey. Vivakshita atraiva vartate kintu hataha iti viruddha pratitihi bhavati. So hataha, those kings have been killed. That is the viruddha pratiti, or the opposite meaning that comes in our mind. Now with this, vakya doshas are over, and then we have the padaika dosha. So padaika dosha, he only gives us some of the padaika dosha, padamsha dosha or padaika dosha, in the sense, he does not give everything. This is just a sample that he gives. He only gives seven of the doshas: shruti katu, nihatartham, nirarthakam, avachakam, ashlilam, sandigdham and neyartham. These are the only doshas that he gives example for. The rest we have to try to understand as we go. So for the first one, shruti katu is the example he takes. Shruti katu padagatam we saw kartarthyam, where the entire pada kritartha, kritarthasya bhavaha kartarthyam. He used that word to show how the Shrungara Rasa is blocked, or it is pratibandhakam here because of that one word where the parushakshara are being used. If for Vakyagatam, he took the example of Bhatikavyam, where he said, so adhyaishta vedana, yagana, ajaishta, and all that. So where many words had that parushatvam. Now, for Padaikadeshagatam, he gives us the example of Padaikadeshe yathasambhavam krameṇa udaharanam. So the first shloka he gives is alam, atichapalatvat, swapnamayopamatvat, parinati virasatvat, sangamena anganayaha, iti yadi shatakritvaha, tattvamalochayamaha, tadapina harinakshim, vismaranti antarat, vismaratyantaratma. This he also gives another example, Tadgaccha Siddhyai, from Kumarasambhavam also. Now, some may understand that some may feel that there is no Shruti Katu dosham in this shloka. That's why he gives the next shloka. Let's look at this first. So, Shruti, sorry, Alam Atichapalatvat. Now, here, Anganayaha Sangamena Parinati Virasatvat Alam. Anganayaha Sangamena Alam. That's your main sentence. Anganayaha Sangamena, association with a woman. So this is someone who is a person who is attached to a lady, but he wants to let go of that attachment. So he says, enough of my attachment towards this person. So Nayaka, or a person who wants to let go of these attachments and take up sannyasa, he is looking at this girl and saying, Anganayaha Sangamena Alam, enough of my attachment towards this woman. What are the reasons that he gives for this attachment, for saying that enough of this? Ati chapalatvat. It's very fickle. Ati chapalam. the association that I have is very, very fickle. It is asthiram, so ati chapalatvat, asthiratvat. How is it asthiram? Why is it not very fixed, this attachment? Swapna mayopamatvat. Second hetu he gives is, he says it is very similar to swapna and maya. Swapna and maya, you may ask, it is seems very similar. But swapnam is created by our own imagination, our own manas, our own chitta vritti. Swa chitta vritti matra kalpita, swapna. Whereas maya can be induced by something else also. In the sense, like a magician throws an illusion in front of us, it is not because of our chitta vritti that we get deluded by it. It is not that swapna. Whereas if a magician shows it, it is actually because he is trying to use methods of vanchana or mantram, etc. To cover our reality and show us an illusion. So this woman, this attachment towards this woman is very similar to that. It is either you just wake up one day and find that she is not anymore in love with you. So that is like waking up from a dream. Or as and when you are in that relationship, it seems as if everything was true, but at the same time, it seemed like real, but something had happened at that point of time and she had created an illusion. So it was either her creation or my creation. So a one-sided crush can be like swapna, whereas if someone else is cheating, it can be maya. So swapna mayopamatvathu. Swapna mayopamatvathu anganayaha sangamena alam. Enough of this attachment because it's reminding me of an illusion or a dream. Parinati virasatvat. Very important. At the end of that, you know, the relationship, once the relationship breaks, there is a virasa. The same things that seemed beautiful, rasamayatvam, is absent at the end of that relationship. So parinati virasatvat. Actually, in Uttaramacharitam, he'll say, where even the, you know, that rasam that exists even in Vardhakyam, that is the deep love that should exist between a husband and wife, between Rama and Sita. He will say, Advaitam Sukhadukkayoho. So Parinati Virasatvat. Parinati is at the end of that relationship, it is the Virasa. There is a change in the attitude towards each other. Hence, Anganayaha Sangamena Alam. Iti yadi shatakrit. Shatakritvaha, not once, but 100 times if I keep on analyzing. See, that is the tattvam, that is the reality. See, it is ati chapalam, swapramayopama, and pariniti virasam. I can analyze it 100 times, even then, tadapi. Harinakshim antaratma na vismarati. This antaratma, this manas is not able to forget that lady. Harinakshim. She's got beautiful eyes like a doe, like a female deer. Harinakshim tam antaratma mama manaha na vismarati. It's not able to forget that. Huh? What to do? Sannyasam is a very difficult stage in life. So, coming back to the dosham here in the shloka, atra tvat iti. So tva, the words he uses, there are many places where he uses tvam. Ati chapalatvat, mayopamatvat, virasatvat, tattvam alochayamaha, kshatakritvaha. See, these are all samyuktakshara which are katu and which is not... Yeah, actually there is a tug of war between Shantarasam and Shringara Rasam here. So this, it removes the Shantarasam, and the Shringara Rasam is actually trying to come to the surface where he says Harinakshim Navismarati Antaratma. So which means the ultimate rasam here that needs to be pointed out is Shringara, and these Samyuktakshara are a Shringara Virodhi. Okay. So that is why he takes this, and this tva is not in the entire padam. Ati chapala is fine. Ati chapala tvam, chapalasya bhavaha chapala tvam. That tva is only a pratyayam, so it is only pada ekadeshe vartate. Natu सम्पूर्णपदे पद एकदेशे विद्यमानत्वात् इट् इस् अ दोष. सम् मैट् से दट् दिस् इस् अनुभवविरोधम् इन् द सेन्स् वेन् ऐ see shruti katu is what it should be harsh to the ears, whereas if when I recite this shloka alam ati swaparatvat swapnam ayopamatvat parinati virasatvat sangamena anganayah, there is no shruti katutvam as such, where there is no dha tha cha, it is not harsh enough, some might feel. Hence, he gives another example as yathava tadgaccha siddhyai kurudeva karyam arthoyam arthantara labhyayeva apekshate pratyayam anga labhyai bijankurav pragudaya divambhaha. Disclaimer is I cannot accept that there is a dosha in this shlokam for the first, for very fact that Kutus Kumara Sambhava and Kalidasa has written this shloka. But we will look at how Mamata points out the dosha. So, tad gaccha siddhi kuru deva karyam. Manmatha approaches Indra. So, Indra calls for Manmatha and says, he doesn't say anything actually. So, he just calls Manmatha. Manmatha comes to the darbar, Indra's darbar, and he starts off by himself. You know, what do you want? You tell me. Which apsaras do you want to, possess? Which sage's wife do you want? You know, which girl is not even accepting you? So tell me, do you want any, is there any rishi who is, doing tapas and you want that tapas to be destroyed? Is someone trying to come to your position? Do you want his work to be destroyed? I will do it. Then at the end, he says, Kuryam harasyapi pinaka panehe dharyachitim kemama dhanminaha. Even if it is Pinaki, which is Shiva, I will destroy his concentration. Don't worry. Kemama dhanminaha. Who can be equal to me? Who can compete with me? He starts off, he ends with that shloka, Athoru desha, the way Kalidasa describes, it's like a beautiful drama that he will describe. So Indra, immediately, the moment Manmatha says that, he takes his leg, he has been putting one leg on the other, and Atha Urudeshat. So from the thigh, he takes out his leg and puts it on. Now, that is what I want. So he puts forth his idea and says, you have to go and ensure that Shiva and Parvati somehow come together and Skanda's Utpatti happens. Kartikeya's Utpatti happens. So that is the Bijam here, which needs, the Bijam or the sprout needs water before. So Bijankuraha Udayat Prak Yata Ambaha Apekshate, just as how the Bija Ankura, Bijasya Ankuraha, the sprout of a seed requires water before its udaya, before it can bloom into a plant, it needs water. So bijankuraha praku udayat I ambaha yatha iva apekshate tatha, just as how it expects. Now in the same way, this artham that is there in front of us, I am artha, this artha is which is Shiva Parvati Sangamaha, that artha needs one arthantara labhyaha. It can only happen with the force of another artha. Arthantara, another artha, another prayojanam, another karanam. Labhyaha, it is attained, it can be attained only by an arthantara. Hence, Anga labdhyai pratyayam apekshate. So it requires a pratyayam or a karta or a karanam for it, for its anga labdhyai. Anga labdhyai, swarupa labdhyai, swarupa labhaya. It requires something else. He says it in a very nice manner to avoid gramyatvam and ashlila dosham. So he says arthantara is actually Shiva Parvati sangamam. That Shiva Parvati Sangamaika Labhyaha Arthaha Skanda Utpatti Nama Arthaha Angalabhyai Swarupa Labhaya Pratyayam Apekshate Pratyayam Kartaram Apekshate Athava Karanam Apekshate Tat Karanam Cha Manmatha Rupaha Kama Rupaha. So Tad Gaccha. सो गो देवकार्य सिद्ध्यै तत् सिद्ध्यै गच्छ गो फॉर योर सक्सेस सिद्ध्यै गच्छ कुरु देवकार्यं देवानां कार्यम् एतत् न तु मम कार्यम् इट् इस् नाट् यु आर् नाट् डूयिङ्ग् दिस् वर्क् ओन्ली फर् मी No, the entire host of devas are going to be benefited from this because kanda utpattir bhavet tarakasurasya hananam cha bhavet he is putting forth that to manmatha in a very raw he is a king he cannot say it in a very sweet and nice manner he is not wooing a lady here for him to use nice words so I will not accept that there is a shruti katutvam here anyway okay so tad gachha let me give the meaning of the shloka once more so tad gachha so hence tat tat tasmat karanat so this tasmat karanat you have to know the entire context to understand why he says that tad gachha hence go why because only I mean, Guror Niyogat, Guror Niyogat, Nagendra Kanya, Sthanam Tapasyantam Adityakaya. Sthanam, Shiva is doing tapas and Guror Niyogat, because of her father's orders, Parvati is serving him there in that forest. So this is the opportune moment where you can go for your success. Tad Tasmat Karanat Tad Siddhyai Gaccha. Go for your success. Deva Karyam Kuru. Do this work which is beneficial for the entire host of devas so devakaryam etat kuru next I am arthaha this skanda utpattihi nama arthaha prayojanam this karyam this result that we want is actually arthantara labhyaha eva arthantaraha karyantarenaiva labhyaha karyantarascha kim atra शिव पार्वत्योः सङ्गमैकलभ्यः एण्ड् दट् फोर् दट् अङ्गलब्ध्यै दट् स्वरूपलब्ध्यै इन् आर्डर् टु गेट् दट् कार्यं टु बिकम् अ सक्सेस् प्रत्ययम् अपेक्षते इट् एक्स्पेक्ट्स् अ कारणं वाट् इस् दट् कारणं कामरूपः मन्मथरूपकारणं कर्तारम् अपेक्षते सो विदौट् मन्मथस् प्रेसेन्स् दोस् टु आर् नाट् गोयिङ्ग् टु जायिन् The dosha here is atra dhyai dhyai iti katu he says so here siddhyai is here and then angalabdhyai these are the two parts where he says because it is vakyakatam dosham you have to have more no so oh, sorry padaika desham where siddhi siddhyai is in chaturthi vibhakti labdhi and labdhyai is in chaturthi vibhakti and the dha bha id dha and ib dha that samyuktakshara and the purushaksharam that he uses are also he says it is dosha why because it is shringara rasam where the nayika nayaka vrittanta varnanam is being happening where is the prakritam here it is the context here and hence these shruti katu purushakshara words should not be used okay let's move on to the next one otherwise I will keep on saying that manmata mamata is wrong in this I don't want to say that so siddhyai and labdhyai are the words that are problem here now the next one is nihatartham and let me go back to here nihatartham we saw in padagatam it was shonitam where the word shonita was actually used in the meaning of red whereas in the artham and it was used in the meaning of red but shonitam is never used in the meaning of red so you can go back to the padagata dosham and vakyagata dosham to have an understanding of what the difference is and now we are going to look at the padaika dosham the shloka here is yaschapsaro vibhrama mandaranam sampadayitrim shikharair vibharti valahakacheyad vivakta ragam akalasandhyamiv dhatumattam okay even though this is kumarasambhava I have to accept that there is a dosham here what he says is padaika dosha let's look at the meaning of the shlokam and then go to the dosham he is describing Himavat Parvata, and he starts off with Astittarasyam Dishi Devatatma Himalayo Nama Nagadhirajaha. And how is this Himalayas? He describes it with Yam Sarvashaila Parikalpita. He uses the Yat Shabda for each and every shloka to describe who that Himavat Parvata is. And in that process, he says, Yascha Apsaro Vibrama Mandananam Sampadayitrim Shikarair Bibhatti Malaha Kacheda Vibhakta Ragam Akalasandhyam Iva Dhatumattam Yahacha Dhatumattam Bibharti Shikaraihi Yahacha Yaha Himavat Parvatam Himaman धातुमत्ताम धातुमान सो धातवः अस्य संति इति धातुमान वन हू हैज धातु धातु मींस मिनरल्स सो द वर्ड धातु ईच वन यू हैव टू टेक कॉन्टेक्स्टुअली हियर बिकॉज वी आर डिस्क्राइबिंग हिमवत पर्वत वी टेक धातु एज मिनरल्स दोज यू नो रेड कलर पाउडर एंड रेड स्टोन्स एंड वॉट एवर मिनरल्स दट आर देर सो मेनली हियर He is only trying to describe the reddish minerals that are there on the Himavat Parvata. So that is the Dhatu. If you look at Vyakaranam, Dhatu means verb. If you look at Ayurveda, Dhatu is Sapta Dhatavaha, where it is Vasa, Majja, all your nerves, lymph nodes and all these things. So contextually here, the meaning of Dhatu is minerals. So Dhatuman is a person who has those minerals, dhatu mataha bhavaha dhatu matta, which means it again comes back to refer dhatu or minerals. So dhatu mattam, the quality of a person, the quality of having minerals, he has that in his shikaraihi bibarti, with his shikara, with his peaks. With his peaks, he bears the quality of having minerals, which actually means he has minerals. So on his peaks, he has a lot of red colored dhatu. Now, this is actually sampadayitri. It provides makeup for the apsaras. Apsaro vibrama mandananam sampadayitrim. Now this dhatu, these minerals which are present on the top of the peaks of Himavat Parvata, yaha shikaraihi dhatumattam bibharti. And how is that dhatumatta? How are the minerals? They actually provide sampadayitri mandanam, a decorative item for apsaro vibhrama. Apsara strees need makeup to show their graces, hav bhav. They have to show their graces, and for that they use makeup, and for makeup they come to Himavat Parvata. They exist there, so they live there, and they use this dhatu, these minerals, to as a paste for face paint or whatever. So this provides a makeup for them. So apsaro vibrama mandananam sampadayitrim dhatumattam bibharti. Further, when you look at it, imagine those peaks of the Himalayas, which are reddish in color, and it is interspersed with clouds. So, valahaka cheda vibhakta ragam. Valahaka meghaha tesham chedena, they are the khandena. So, the khandeshu, meghanam khandeshu, valahaka chedeshu, vibhakta raga. The colors are interspersed within the megha, within the clouds. So what happens is the clouds reflect the dhatu, the minerals, the red color that is there on Himavat Parvata, the clouds all reflect it, and it seems as if there is an akala sandhya, an untimely dusk time has come up there. Akala sandhyamiva dhatumattam vibharti. So yahacha apsaro vibrama mandananam sampadayitrim valahaka cheda vibhaktaragam akala sandhyam iva dhatumattam shikaraihi vibharti saha himalaya namana gadhiraja asti. That is where you go and combine it. Otherwise, we will say it is an avimrishta videyamsha dosha, where the tachabdamsha is absent. So that is connected with the prakaranam. Here, yaha dhatumattam bibharti. Now that part is over. The dosham that he points out here is padaika desha gata. So padaika deshe nihatartham. Nihatartham means where the another not viruddhartha but an undesirable meaning comes to the mind. Matta dhatuman dhatumatta, the vyutpatti that I gave for dhatumatta is dhatavaha asya santi iti dhatuman dhatumataha bhavaha dhatumatta. It is a pratyayam there. Whereas just that amsha of matta gives us the meaning of matta, matta shabdaha kshibarthe nihatarthaha. Kshiba means intoxicated. Mattaha, madamattaha. It is as if he is intoxicated. So this dhatu matta means it gives the meaning of intoxication in our mind. Excuse me. It gives us the meaning of intoxication, which is not needed here. Okay. So kshibarthe or unmattarthe atra. So nihatartham actually means one artha completely covers up another artha. That is your nihatartham. Right, so when I say the word shonitam, the meaning of rudhira completely submerges the meaning of red color. In the same way here, when I say dhatumatta, instead of giving rise to the meaning, immediately the meaning that gives rise is only intoxication and not dhatumataha bhavaha dhatumatta is something that will come only after we go further and into the meaning of the shloka. Otherwise, the first thing that arises is matta. Matta means intoxicated, and that meaning is so matvartham is nihanyate. Matta kshibartaha eva pratiyate. Matvartaha tu atra nihanyate athava tirodhiyate. So it is being hidden. Hence, the dosha here is nihatarthatvam, which is a padaika dosha. Okay. Now next, let's go to the next dosha. I will go to the slides for this because it's there are a couple of things that he mentions here. The next artham is next dosha is nirarthakam. For nirarthakam, there was only a padagata dosham that we saw. There was no vakyagata dosham for it. In padagata dosham, we said chadi shabdaha, where cha, vai, tu, hi, etc. are used where there is no enforcement of the meaning there. Mamahi Gauri Utpulla, we saw that shloka in Padagatam where he says Mamahi Gauri, he should be used for conveying the meaning of indeed, whereas there is no such thing that conveyed that meaning, and it was only used for Padapuranam. In many Purana, Itihasa, etc., he would have used vai, tu and all without any meaning, but in Kavyam you cannot do that. Padapuranarthameva is not something that is appreciated in Kavyam, and it is treated as a dosha. The dosham name is Nirarthakam. Now here, in the Padaika Desha Gatam, Adau Anjana Punja Lipta Vapusham, Shvasanila Ullasita Ullasita Protsarpat Virahanalena Chastataha Santapitanam Drisham, Sampratyeva Nishekam Ashru Payasa, Devasya Cheto Bhuvaha Bhallinamiva Panakarma Kurute Kamam Kurangekshana. Here Kurangekshana Kamam Kurute Bhallinam Iva Panakarma Kamam Kurute. So the context here is a girl who is going to be separated from her lover, from her Nayaka. She is it seems as if she is sharpening the arrows of Manmatha. So Devasya Cheto Bhuvaha Chetasi Yaha Udbhavati Saha Cheto Bhuvaha Devaha Cheto Bhuhu Devaha, which is Manmatha. So Manmatha or Manobhavaha, Manmatha, Manmatha's arrows, Bhalli, Bhalli is arrow, and Bhalli Nam Panakarma Iva. Panakarmam is sharpening the arrows. So what do you do when sharpening? It is a metal in the corner. So actually, Manmatha's arrows are Pushpabana. He is imagining, fancying here. So it is Utpreksha Alankara actually. So he is fancying as if, just like how if it is made of metal, you first treat it with some acid or something, you put on something there on top of it, and then you blow air and make the fire, and you show this arrow into the fire, and then immediately you sprinkle water on it for shaping it, for making it sharp. Now this, have this in mind in your background when he is describing the lady here. Adau prathamam, what she does is anjana punja lipta papusham. All of these are adjectives for drisham. Her eyes are first smeared with the anjana punja anjana vapuhu, which is for the drish drik. Her eyes have the form which have been smeared with anjana. Its surface has been smeared with anjanam or kajal. Then the other adjective is santapitanam. It has been made hot by the fire. What is the fire here? Viraha anala. This viraha anala, the fire of separation, has made these eyes even more hot. So viraha analena, how is that viraha anala? It is protsarpati. It is spreading everywhere. So that she is experiencing that separation, and that separation is spreading everywhere. It is ullasita. It has been pravardhita. Ullasita, it is increased by shvasa anila, because of the size that she has, nishvasa. She's very upset, so she is taking heavy breaths and sighs. And because of that anila, shvasasya anilena, ullasita vardhita, protsarpati sarvatra prasarati viraha analena, viraha agnina, santapitanam drisham, drisha. Now, when these are all, so when the eye is so hot, when something is hot, you immediately sprinkle water on it to reduce the coolness. So what does she do here? Samprattyeva, immediately, ashru payasa yat nishekam kurute. So yat, immediately her eyes, because she is separated from her nayaka, her eyes start tearing up immediately. So ashru payasa, with the waters or the, with the tears, she nishekam kurute, she sprinkles it in such a manner that devasya cheto bhuvaha bhallinam panakarma iva kurute. Panakarma tikshnam, tikshnikaranam. So it seems she sprinkles her tears in such a manner that it seems as if Manmatha's sharpening his arrows. Okay. Now he goes to discussion for the shloka. First, the vritti for the shloka is atra drisham iti bahuvachanam nirarthakam kurange kshanayaha ekasyaha eva upadanat. Now the word he uses here is drik. It should be drishoho. She has only two eyes. She is not neither Shakti nor Shiva for her to have three eyes and for the poet to use drisham in bahuvachanam. So the bahuvachanam in drik shabda, drisham iti shabde vyate bahuvachanam vidyate tat nirathakam atra. So it is useless. There is no specificity or there is no specific implication to use a bahuvachanam here. Okay. Hence, why the kurangekshanayaha ekasyaha eva, and that kurangekshanaha is not there. Kurangekshana, or the girl, the beautiful girl, is singular. It is not a plural word there. It is not kurangekshanaha in bahuvachanam. Hence, only one lady is mentioned. Satas ekasyaha eva upadanat. Because only one lady is being mentioned. Drisham iti bahuvachanam atra nirarthakam. Next, he goes to the discussion. Nacha alasa valitaihi ityadivat vyapara bhedat bahutvam vyaparanam anupatatvat nacha vyapare atra drikshabdo vartate. this is the line that is given in the text. I've just broken it down into Purvapakshi and Siddhanti, because the shloka that he mentions is not there in the text, and it is only present in the Vyakhyana. Now he says, Nacha alasavalitaihi ityadivat vyapara bhedat bahutvam. Bahuvachanam is can be used in places where you are talking of a plurality in the functions of what it does. For example, the example shloka that the Purvapakshi starts. So when you look at nacha, immediately you remove the nacha first and then look at the words that are there inside, and that is the Purvapakshi's words, which is alasa valitaihi ityadivat vyapara bhedat bahutvam. That is your Purvapakshi's argument. He says alasa valitaihi ityadivat. That is a shloka that he takes from Amarushatakam, where it is alasa valitaihi premardra ardraihi muhur mukuliyikritaihi kshanam abhimukaihi lajja lolaihi nimesha parang mukaihi hridayanihitam bhavakutam bamadbihi iva ikshanaihi kathaya sukriti koyam mugdhe tvaya adhya vilokyate iti asmin shloke vyapara bhedat bahutvam ikshanaihi iti shabde iti chetna. The reason that the Siddhanti gives is again vyaparanam anupatattvat. You have to take it from there. Okay, now let's look at this shloka. Why the Purvapakshi takes up the shloka and says, see, in the earlier shloka we saw, he says drisham, right? That drisham is in bahuvachanam and it cannot exist in bahuvachanam because kurangekshana is in singular, right? So he takes up another example and says this is talked of as a very great shloka. Let's look at the meaning here. He mugdhe, the last line. He mugdhe, O innocent one. Kathaya, tell me. So one lady, a sakhi, is asking a naika, who has suddenly, she has started falling in love with someone and she is looking at another person, a purusha, with her eyes. So she is asking, the sakhi is asking her, he mugdhe, kaha sukriti ayam tvaya adya vilokyate kathaya kathaya, tell me tvaya adya, by you, which is this, you know, fortunate one? Sukriti ayam kaha tvaya adya vilokyate, who is this fortunate one who is being looked upon by you? With what? Ikshanaihi, with your the literal meaning here is by your sights, with your eyesight. So who is this who is being looked at by your eyesights? You can use that ikshanam is the vyapara here. It is not the eye as such. It is only the looks, with your looks. So the everything else is an adjective for that ikshanaihi. Alasa valitaihi. Alasa valitaihi, it is very alasa, alasyena valitaihi, it is very slightly curved because you're lazily looking at him. Prema ardra ardraihi, it is drenched with prema, with love. Muhuhu mukuli krataihi, again and again you are closing your eyes slightly like a bud, mukulam. And then kshanam abhimukaihi, for a moment you just look at him straight, abhimuka, in front of him. But then at the same time, lajja lolaihi, these are all anubhava that in the Shringara Rasam. It's a very beautiful Shringara Rasa shloka. So lajja lolaihi, the moment you are in front of him, at the same time you're also shy. That's why she says mugdha, it's a mugdha naika. So lajja lolaihi, because of shyness, you're immediately, the eyes are lolam. It is moving here and there because of shyness. Nimesha parang mukaihi, but it is not completely closing also. If she is totally afraid or totally shy and not looking at all, then it would be nimesha, completely closed, but that is also not there. So nimesha parang mukaihi, you are also, those eyesights are also averse to completely closing. So hridaya nihitam bhava akutam bhamadbihi iva, it is as if the eyesights are Abhamadbihi, it is pouring forth the bhava akutam, the eagerness of eagerness and the bhava, the emotions that are there in the hridayam. Hridaya nihitam bhava akutam bhamadbiriva ikshanaihi, with these தமிழ்ல தான் கரெக்டா வருது. இந்த பார்வைகளினால், பார்வை இஸ் த வேர்ட் தட் ஹி மென்ஷன்ஸ் ஹியர், தர்ஷனம் ஈக்ஷணம். இட் இஸ் நாட் தி ஐ, பட் த டிஃப்ரெண்ட் ஆக்ஷன்ஸ் தட் தி ஐ யூசஸ், தட் இஸ் ஈக்ஷணம். சோ கதைய சுகிருதி கோயம் துவயா அத்திய விலோக்கியதே, ஹூ இஸ் பீங் லுக்ட் அப்பான் பை யூ இத்தியாதிவத். இந்த ஸ்லோக வி ஃபைண்ட் தட் ஈக்ஷண இஸ் பகுவச்சனம். சோ If you accept that this is a Shringara Rasad Shloka and that Ikshana is not a dosha here, Ityadivat Vyapara Vedat, because there are different actions that are being represented by the Ikshana. One Ikshanam is Valitam, another is Ardrardra Darshanam, another is Mukulikaranam, another is Abhimukikaranam, Lolam, Parangmukha, Nimesha Parangmukha. These are all the different vyaparas that are being done by the I. Iti vyapara bhedat, kriya bhedat, bahutvam, bahuvachanam, iti chet. See, in this shloka, it is there. Why are you not accepting that drisham can also indicate vyapara bheda or bahutva vyapara? Why? For that, the Siddhanti says, iti nacha, iti chet na. So that na is actually the Siddhanti's na. That is there. So iti na, what is the reason that the Siddhanti gives? Vyaparanam anupatatvat. There are no vyaparas in that shloka, earlier shloka. There are no different vyapara. Now, how can you say? Immediately the Purupaksha again starts the next question. Nacha vyapare atra drikshabdo vartate. Here also you remove the nacha and say vyapare atra drikshabdaha vartate. So he says, Purupakshi says, no, vyapara means kriya. Kriyayam, asmin shloke, what is that shloka? Adav anjanam, the earlier shloka. In that shloka, he says, drik is the shabda that is being used to indicate vyapara or kriya. Siddhanti says, nacha. Nacha, ityukte, nacha atra drik shabdaha vyaparaarthe upayuktaha. In the sense, drik is only the organ I, that cannot be in Bahuvachanam. He does not use Darshanam. If he had used Darshanam instead of Drisham, then you can say Darshana, Darshananam. Then the Bahutvam Bahuvachanam would have fit and there would be no dosha. Since he used the word Drisham, Drik, that Drik Shabda, he does not indicate the Kriya, it only indicates the organ I. Get it? Now, atraiva kurute. Now, this is another section that he goes. Now, till this, he has talked about what is the dosham in the shloka. Adav anjana punja lipta vapusham is the shlokam where there is a dosha. And drisham is the word that has bahuvachanam, which is nirarthakam. In this context, there is no necessity for using plural for drik. And the Purupakshi asks, in the other shloka in Amarushatakam, he has used Ikshanaihi and that plural work. Oh, why cannot we use it in the same manner in this shloka? The Siddhanti says, there are no plurality of actions mentioned in this. Vyaparanam bahutvam atra na upayuktam. Then he says, nana drik iti shabda represents that vyapara. He says, that drik is only that chakshur indriyasya vyavaharaha eva natu darshana vyaparasya vyavaharaha. Hence the Siddhanti closes that section. And then Mammata, Siddhanti is Mammata here. He says there is also another dosha in the same shloka, which is kurute. Now the kurute, atra eva kurute iti atmane padamapi anarthakam. பிரதானக்ரியாபலஸ்ய கர்த்தர சம்பந்தே கர்த்தர அபிப்ராய கிரியாபல அபாவாத். That's the line that Mammata gives in the Vritti. Here the word kurute is given in Atmanepadi. Karoti is usually used and kurute is in Atmanepada form. Atmanepadam, an Ubayapadi Dhatu. The can be used, an Ubhayapadi Dhatu can be used in both Parasmaipadi and Atmaripadi. It depends on the meaning that is there. So he says the sutram that Panini gives is Swaritam Nyitaha Kartra Abhipraye Kriyapale. So Swarita Nyitaha, Swarita Inya It. So those are the three words that are there. So you take it as Swarita It Samyakaha. Any dhatu, so the, in dhatu pata, Panini has just given all the dhatus as a list, and he has given swarams for all of that, like udatta, anudatta, and swarita. Anything that is with a swarita itta samnya, these are all vyakarana. You need to know the entire vyakarana shastram to understand. So I'm just giving a little bit background, that's all, not much. So swarita itta samnya, and then if any dhatu has the nya, Dukrinya, that is what we are looking at here. And Dukrinya, it Kuru Kru Dhatu ends with the Nya. That is a it. That is, it is not used for any grammatical operation in the Ashtadhyayi. So Nyakara Itsamyakahacha Tasmat Dhatoho. After that, Dhatu Atmanepada is put. When there is a condition here, the clause here is Kartra Abhipraye Kriyapale. Yadi kriyayaha phalam kartra abhipraye vartate. Kartra abhipraye ityukte kartari sambaddaha bhavati. Athava kartaram abhipraiti. Abhipraiti means kartaram gacchati. Kartra abhiprayena uktam. In the sense, the if the result of the action goes to the doer of the action, then it is atmanepadi. Simple example, mata pachati, mata pachate. You go to someone's house, you ask your friend, you know, can I eat? And your friend replies, mata pachati. It is the pachati, the verb is used in Parasmaipadi. And he's saying, okay, she has cooked for everybody. Parasmai, for another person. If he replies, mata pachate, vayam bahir gatva khadamaha. Which means mata apachate atmanepadi, she has only cooked for herself. Our plan is to go out and eat. We cannot expect food from my mother. So that pachate paka kriya, doer of the action. Only in that situation we use atmanepadi. Okay. Atreva kurute iti atmanepadam anarthakam. Now in the present shloka, why has the poet used kuringekshana kamam kurute? She does it yathecham kurute. She does this work with her eyes. You know, she cries with her eyes. The result of that is, and that, you know, yatha devasya cheto bhuvaha panakarma iva kurute. Just sharp, just like how Manmatha sharpens his arrows. Why does Manmatha sharpen his arrows? Manmatha sharpens his arrows so that he can win over the entire world. So just as how Manmatha sharpens this, does she cry to win over the entire host of ladies? That is to show that she is better than the others. That is why she is crying. There is no connection there to that. Right? So the Kurute Padam, Pradana Kriya Phalasya. What is the Pradana Kriya? Ballinam Panakarma Iva Kurute Ityetadeva Atra Esha Eva Kriya Asmin Shloke. Tasyaha Palam. What is the result of that? If Manmatha sharpens his arrow, it means he is trying to win over the world. So this, applying the same idea to the lady, it should mean sakala vanita vijaya rupam eva phalam bhavitavyam. And that phalam, that sakala vijayaha, it is not for her. Her idea is not to win over the entire world. She is only expressing her viraha. That the result of this is not for herself. Correct? So kartra asambandhe api kartari avidyamanatva kurangekshana rupe kartari pradana kriya phalam, which is the sakala vanita vijaya rupam phalam, कर्तरी कुरंगे क्षणायाम असंबंधे अविद्यमानत्वे बिकॉज इट डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट इन दैट लेडी हू इज द डूअर कर्तृ अभिप्राय क्रियाफल अभावात् कर्तृ अभिप्राय क्रियाफले एव आत्मनेपदम् उपयोक्तुं शक्यते whereas that is absent here kartra abhipraya kriya phalasya abhavaha atra vidyamanatvat atmane padam atra nirarthakam so this is the second dosha that he says in the same shloka where the first dosha was drisham which is also anarthakam nirarthakam kurute that atmane pada is also irrelevant and he points that out in the second shloka he points out in the same shloka he points out the second dosha in the shloka okay I think he stops with this and then goes to the one minute next is avachaka dosha so I hope you understood this if there is any questions just send me a message and or we can and I will address it during the next session okay namaste